In the last video, we calculated density of charge carriers in a conduction band. Now, this topic, I'm going to calculate the density of holes. I'm trying to calculate the density of holes in a valencing band. The same process I'm following once again to calculate the density of holes in a valency band. Here I'm considering the valency band. This is the valency band. This is the conduction band. This is the intrinsic Fermi level. Let us assume there are n number of energy levels in a valency band. Here I am considering some of the energy levels whose difference of energy level is E plus dE and dE. The difference in energy level is dE. In that, let dP be the number of holes available in the valency band. This can be written as dP is equal to Z of E dE, the density of holes available in the valency band, and the probability function of holes. This Z of E dE is the density of states available in the valency band. This can be written as Z of E dE can be written as 4 pi by h cube 2 mh star. This is the effective mass of the hole, 3 by 2. So here I am writing EV minus E whole to power of half dE. Similarly, the probability of finding the electron plus probability of finding the hole is equal to 1. From this I am calculating the hole probability function, 1 minus f of e into e. This is for electron, this is for hole. From this, 1 minus 1 by 1 plus exponential e minus ef by kbt. From this I'll get the value exponential e minus ef by kbt. So I'll substitute this equation number 1. This is the equation number 2. I'll substitute in the final equation. This is the final equation. So if I substitute, dP equal to 4 pi by h cube 2 mh star 3 by 2 EV minus E whole to the power of half into exponential E minus EF by kBT into dE. So this is the with respect to only dE, but I have to calculate the total available number of charge carriers from here to here. This can be calculated by integrating the above equation P is equal to, so this is the maximum, it's from minimum is minus infinity. At start with the minimum, minus infinity to the EV from here to here. In the previous case, I calculated from EC to the top. Now I'm coming from minus infinity to the valency band. This is the energy level EV. So 4 pi by h cube by 2 mh star 3 by 2 EV minus E whole to power of half exponential E minus EF by kB to dE. If you solve this above equation, so you are getting the answer. After mathematical simplification, after simplification, the P is equal to number of holes is equal to the similarly the same expression like a number of electrons 2 pi mh star kbt by h square whole to power of 3 by 2 exponential minus ef minus ev by kbt. So this is the density of holes available in the valency band. If you equate the number of electrons and number of holes, you will find the position of Fermi level. So in the starting, we considered that the Fermi level is the probability of finding the maximum number of charge carriers. In this case, in the intrinsic semiconductor, if the electron leaves from here to here, the electron leaves from here to here, one electron, one hole. So similarly, the equal number of holes and equal number of electrons are there. So due to this, the Fermi level lies exactly at the center between the valency band and the conduction band. So this can be proved by equating the number of holes and number of electrons to find the position of Fermi level. To solve this, I am equating the number of electrons is equal to the number of holes. So this can be written as n is equal to, I am equating number of electrons 2 pi m star kT by h square whole to power of 3 by 2 exponential minus ec minus ef by kBT. That should be equated with the number of holes, the same expression, see 2 pi mh star kBT by h square whole to power of 3 by 2 exponential minus ef minus ev by kBT. if you equate both this, we'll get the final expression is ef is equal to, if you equate the final expression, this becomes 3 kBT by 4 log mh star effective mass by mh star plus ev plus ec by. So after simplifying, we get this expression. So this expression will be the position of Fermi level. Let T is equal to 0 Kelvin. I'm writing T is equal to 0 Kelvin. The Fermi level lies exactly at the center between the valency band and the conduction band. So this is the expression for the intrinsic semiconductor. I'm drawing once again. So this is the valency band, this is the conduction band. The Fermi level position exactly halfway between the conduction band and the valency band. So this exactly half, this exactly this one. Exact lies between the EC plus EV by 2. This is calculated by calculating the number of holes and number of electrons by equating this. I am getting the Fermi level position is the lies between the valency band and the conduction band. Then one more expression to calculate the intrinsic carrier density. The intrinsic carrier density, carrier concentration. The expression is intrinsic carrier concentration. ENI. This can be calculated, the intrinsic carrier concentration. So we know that number of electrons, the number of holes. Okay, so number of holes P is equal to
EN.